All right, Pinarello Bolide TT bike, first ride. This is the 2020 Pinarello Bolide TT bike. And this is the bike of my mate Kian Watts, who rides for the New Zealand Conti team Black Spoke. He said in exchange for me being able to review his TT bike that you guys need to go follow him on Instagram. So I'm gonna put his link here and go give him a follow on Instagram. And if you guys have a bike that you would like me to review, be sure to let me know in the comments down below and I'll be able to get to it in another video. So we all know that this Pinarello is a serious piece of kit. Pinarello is basically the Ferrari of the bike world. So if you've been watching any Grand Tours over the last 5 years, you'll see that this bike has been ridden by some hitters like Chris Froome, Garen Thomas, and the world time trial champion Rowan Dennis. So this is Pinarello's new iteration of the Bolide TT bike, and they call it the Bolide TT. Pinarello claimed that this frame saves over 350 grams from the previous TT bike, and in a size 52, this frame weighs 1,044 grams, which is ridiculously light for a full-blown TT bike. So now moving on to the fully integrated handlebar systems. These are made by Pinarello's little brand Most, so they make all of like the handlebars and the seats and stuff for the Pinarello brand. So the bike comes with this full carbon flush stem that goes into the base bar and is like flush with the top tube here, and this comes stock on every single Bolide frame. So one thing that I really like about this bike is that it has these fully integrated brakes, but they're still in like the normal position that you'd see on a bike that was probably like created back in like the 1800s, 1900s. So this is like a full carbon aero brake, but it's still sitting at the top of the fork where it should be, and it's like the most powerful in that position as well. It's not like hidden behind the wheel or in some stupid place. Sometimes when you have those stupid aero brakes, you grab the lever and it feels a bit squishy, but these ones just feel absolutely perfect. It's like on, off, on, off, and they feel really, really good. And even at the back of the bike, the brake is still at the perfect place. It's still like sitting where it should be. If you look at like a normal old TT bike from like the 80s, this is where the brakes were, just front and back. But Pinarello have these like caps over the top of them. They really help with the airflow and like to keep it really, really aero. And these are clearly really fast bikes because they haven't been slowing people down like Chris Froome or like Garen Thomas. And I just like, again, when you grab the brake, it just works. You can just feel that these brakes actually work. I've had a few TT bikes and a few bikes that have like the bottom bracket mounted brakes, and they're just rubbish. They barely work. And I'm excited to take this bike out on the road and give the brakes a bit of a test to see if having them in the normal position is actually better. So the way that Pinarello have been able to hide this rear brake is that they've flared out these rear seat stays, and they're super, super wide, and the brake just kind of sits in behind there. And then it's just got this little top cap that kind of like screws on. There's one screw there. I guess you can just take that off, which is easy for maintenance. And now we're gonna look at the specific components that Kian is running on his Bolide. So the team has been fitted out with a full Durace DI2 11 speed group set. So it's got Durace rear mech, front mech, shifters, and brakes. So Kian's running this 4II power meter, and I assume that's why he hasn't got the Durace cranks on here. So obviously it's got the most integrated handlebars and stem. One thing that Kian has a little bit different is he's changed the pads, and these are the Aero Coach pads, and he has these sitting ridiculously close. So if I put my arms in here, they are just completely touching. Like, I've never seen a bar set so close, and I'm pretty sure they call this like the praying mantis position. But yeah, I'll be interested to see if I can actually get my shoulders into that. So a lot of people in the TT world are all about their stack height now, and I think Kian's probably got about 50 to 60 millimeters worth of stack on here. So because this bike is DI2, I'm pretty sure the junction box is hidden in this little box in here. So there's obviously two screws to get into that. And I guess you can pop it out and then play around with the junction boxes and the cables. Another few cool aero bits on the Pinarello Bolide TT. So the top of this frame, kind of like, as you can see, it like starts out quite narrow and then it kind of widens all the way down to the bottle cage, and I think that's too, so when the bottle is in the bottle cage, the frame kind of protects it from the wind and makes it a little bit more aero. So the top of the bike all off, Kian's running a Pro TT saddle. This has got the carbon fiber rails, and it kind of has this weird like pointer bit out the back. Don't know if this does anything, but it's a pretty cool touch. So I'm down in Cambridge to film this because Kian lives up in Hamilton, which is just about a 30 minute drive from here. But the reason that we haven't got a disc or like a tri-spoke or a nice deep front wheel is because the team is based in Auckland, and the Black Spoke team, they look after all the race wheels. So Kian's only got a few training wheels at the moment. So hopefully if Black Spoke see this in an upcoming video, we could maybe get the race wheels on and take it for a spin. spin as well. All right, so now we're on to the best part of the video. I'm gonna go take this brand new Pinarello Bellide TT bike for a bit of a spin. All right, this is gonna be my first ride on the Team Black Spokes Pinarello Bellide TT bike. So I'm super excited to see what it's gonna ride like. I am a little bit nervous about trying to get my shoulders into these tiny little narrow bars that Keon's got going on here. I obviously had shoulder surgery about a year and a half ago now, and this is probably the narrowest TT bars I've ever seen in my entire life, so it's going to be quite interesting. Alright, so now we're going to head off for a 30 to 40 minute ride and test out this Pinarello. There we go, first ride on the Pinarello TT bike, and this is just an absolute weapon of a time trial bike. I've had two time trial bikes since I started riding. I had a Rally TT bike, and then I just had that Avanti TT bike. This is about 10 times better than that Avanti TT bike. One big problem that I have with my Avanti is just like the cockpit system. You know, really couldn't use a lot. As you can see here, there's literally four different spaces that you can put your bars out to, like, try to make them wider, and there's so much stack that you can put in there. It's just so much more adjustable, and I like that. That's like my first big plus on this bike. Another thing is that a TT bike and both the brakes just work absolutely perfectly. They're so powerful, so that's my second favorite thing. And then lastly, I just really like the frame design. It just looks really cool. But obviously, if you don't know, this frame, you can buy the frame and the handlebars with no wheels, and I don't know if it comes with a group set, and it's 10,400 New Zealand dollars. So that's like 6,000 USD, I think. So it's flipping expensive for just a frame and bar set, but it is an absolute weapon of a time trial bike. Thanks to Keon for letting me take his bike out for a spin, and if Black Spoke, if you want me to do any more videos for you, I'd be keen, so hit me up on the DMs on Instagram. But that is gonna be the end of this video. If you wanna see me do more time trial bikes, because mostly done road bikes so far, let me know in the comments down below, and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. We'll be right back.